Starts now.
Good evening. It's a disease that you breathe in, which can be difficult for doctors to detect. Last year, the Central Valley had the highest number of valley fever cases reported in the entire state.
23 ABC's Emma Lockhart has more on what lawmakers are doing to help doctors diagnose that disease early on. Emma?
Tim, Jess, I spoke with Assemblymember Rudy Salas today, who's been a vocal advocate in the Capitol for valley fever. One of his bills that would educate doctors on the disease now headed to the governor's desk. Salas's efforts not going unnoticed, especially by those who suffer from the disease.
Had a headache for 6 weeks at this point. I'm nauseous. I've lost a ton of weight. I'm just not looking good. My wife's freaked out. My kids are freaked out.
After weeks of misdiagnosing, Rob Perdee finally found out he had valley fever, the disease caused by breathing in spores of fungus in the soil and dust in the air, leaving everyone susceptible.
Destroy anything in your body. It can go into your bones. People have lost limbs. People have lost eyes. Anything in your body. People have lost kidneys.
Those the more severe cases, but with nearly 3,000 Kern County residents diagnosed in 2017, Assemblymember Rudy Salas took action.
People were coming into my office and just telling me these heart-wrenching stories about how valley fever affected them and their families. I knew we had to do something about it. I promised a lot of the people that were affected by valley fever that I'd make it a big deal up in the Capitol and that we'd try to do something.
Salas bringing three valley fever bills to Governor Jerry Brown's desk this year, one that would educate doctors on the disease, still waiting for Brown's signature.
Assembly Bill 1790 is going to provide physician education, training, resources, and help educate the public about valley fever.
Education that Perdee says is necessary because the disease is commonly misdiagnosed for the flu or common cold.
You know, the new doctor that hasn't been exposed to it, that's who we got to target.
Salas securing $8 million in the state budget for valley fever, $2 million of that going towards that education and awareness. Perdee, who has a severe case of valley fever, is still fighting every day.
When you get off work and you go have a cocktail and hang out with your friends, I'm going to be in bed because I'm going to be coming home from treatment.
But hopeful, calling this new legislation a win for the valley fever community.
And it's been a bad year for valley fever, but we don't know if next year is going to be better or worse. So we can't stop moving forward. We can't start encouraging our legislatures to continue the job that they started.
Now, Perdee says that if you have symptoms that persist even after antibiotics, you should always ask your doctor to test you for valley fever and to wear a mask if you are in dusty areas. Tim, Jess, back to you.
Always good advice, Emma. Thanks so much.